So the question is, to get into some of the kind of more fun things other than just like us talking about public transit, I put together, but we do not have to do, a virtual B-Day bingo game.
Ooh.
For those that were that played Jingle Mingle back in the holidays of last year, this is the same concept.
Oh my. Uh-oh. Where did it go? Oh, there's chat.
So in the chat for the meets. Oh my. I just looked at Owen's cam.
Owen gave himself a bear head.
I was not prepared for seeing a new face. That's awesome.
I could pull the stunt here. I pulled a while back with my LARP group. I have this cardigan hoodie with this hood that goes all the way, like literally will completely cover my face. I had the lights off and I just turned on the camera and joined the meeting with that over my face. It just sat there. And then eventually someone went, God damn it.
I love you all, and I believe I was probably say hello, but I am absolutely passing out because I've been up since 7 this morning. Although I'm not able to go the whole entire thing. I'm going to go.
That's okay. Thanks for stopping in and staying.
But I'm going to stay here on my birthday. I'm going to get out of here, and I will watch the VOD when I get home. So okay, have a good night.
Read or watch Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. It's very appropriate for this year.
Oh, deal. Have a good night, everyone.
Good night, Lloyd.
So when he listens to this later, I will now talk about how I'm not going to take offense that this is the second time that he's been so tired that he's passing out in my presence. Yes, that is a little bit of shade. That's in reference to Chicago. That's in reference to Chicago when we were together hanging out and we had dinner. We had a lovely dinner. Hey, Todd, if you happen to like see or hear about this show as well. So, and then we went out to a bar and we had a drink. And then Todd lovingly gave me a ride home and Lloyd sat in the passenger front seat. And we made jokes about him falling asleep. And no sooner than we made the joke, I think within 30 seconds, he passed out. And missed at least half the car ride back to my hotel. So, yeah. So this is twice now I've seen Lloyd at his, like, I'm going to pass out because I can't stay awake anymore stage.
I mean, he's dedicated, so at least, so, right?
Yes. That's true.
Very appreciative. Okay, so virtual bingo.
All right. So if you click the link, it should open a randomized card. All of the words that have been used include, and some additionals were put in, but these are from the word cloud, which is from our website, which is built off of the keyword tags that Damon has been tracking for I don't know how many hundreds of episodes over time. So these are some of the most popular phrases or statements or words that have come out of podcasts.
Mm-hmm.
First, check your free space.
And of course, the first word for the bingo, why would nobody be surprised? Rest in peace, Tumblr.
Aww.
I don't have that at all.
So, and here's the funny thing is, these are not categorized. You know how like in bingo, you don't really have like 1 through 15 or something? Yeah, this is just a whole randomized thing. So there's no way to know where any of these words are going to fall.
Mm-hmm. I'm looking at my card and I'm a little like, why are you reading this? So
second word, all stars, or all words, I guess I should say second call.
All smarts. Small.
Because this take louder is forming both, not just the main Seawall show, but also a Seawall drag race hosted by Damon and Gary as they venture through the years of American drag race shows. Yes, that's right. They do not do Canada. They do not do Australia. They do not do the UK. But they do America.
For the first time ever, this is past season of All Stars. Jer and I actually watched it.
Cool.
Because as my husband pointed out, it was drag race for people who like Bake Off.
All Stars, the seven?
Yes.
That's fair.
The nice season.
I quite enjoyed watching the producers completely fail to create any drama.
So true.
I mean, you know, they tried, but you know, you could see the moments they tried. And it was finally episode 3 before they finally, you know, gave up and went, oh, okay, this is just going to be all of them having fun and liking each other. So, well, fuck, now we don't know what to do.
I love how David's just holding up his fact fan. And go ahead. All right, call number 3, Edward.
I wonder what that's about.
Must be somebody's name.
Last episode? Entire playlist that we have on YouTube?
Mm-hmm. I'm abused by the fact, so I'm obviously not going to win, but I'm just playing along for the fun of it, and my card does not have him on it, but it has a lot of words that would connect with him.
I have maybe one or two, maybe could count 3. That would connect with him. So,
number 4 is Bacon.
What's not
Bacon?
Why are we not surprised by this?
Bacon. Bacon, not an overrated food.
Thanks.
Number 5, Bob the Drag Queen.
Definitely not anything related to me.
I'm not getting any of these.
Like none of the words are on your call sheet or on your bingo card?
Yeah, like the first one, then I didn't get any.
Yeah, I've had one so far.
We have a lot of different types of tags, so this might last a while.
Oh, yeah?
Well, so I only picked like the top rated ones, but on purpose. So these are the most popular things, believe it or not. Number 6 is LTAK, which would be the Let's Talk About Kink series.
You're just edging my bingo card at this point. Just a little bit, blurbing.
And then LTAS. For call number 7, let's talk about sex series.
I got that.
Yay. I'm not doing so hot.
Call number 8, Star Trek.
Oh, hey, there we go.
No. Reminds me, I need to watch that series again.
Call number 9, Claw.
Claw. The Claw. Claw Law.
I'll get you next time, Gadget.
Dr. Claw.
I'm pretty sure we brought that up at least once.
Yeah.
Get you, Gadget.
Yeah, the joke was made a Claw Law because it wasn't held where it was usually held or something. I think.
Yep.
I don't know.
It was 1 year where it was in LA and people were calling it either LA Claw or
LA Law.
Yeah, LA Law. Because it was it was because Claw is Cleveland Leather Annual Weekend. So they had it in LA, so it made sense to go LA Law.
La la.
Number 10 is podcast.
Indeterminate.
I don't say it. I'm surprised girls called the baby holes on here.
It wasn't tagged enough, I don't think. We do have that clip that's on the YouTube channel.
Maybe it wasn't tagged enough because it was intentional.
Okay. Guess who controls the tags?
Yeah.
Call 11 is fact.
How appropriate.
Speaking of David.
Oh, there it is. Yeah.
Beautiful. Call number 12, Google. I have a funny feeling we've made reference to searching things a lot.
Let me Google that for you.
There's the entire website called that.
Yeah.
Call number 13 is Zazzle.
Get yours now. Zazzle.com/cubsoutloud.
Got at least three examples of things. Well, you can't get this.
That reminds me, I need to work on that. Call 14, queer.
No.
Also kind of related to the last episode.
Yeah.
Call 15, Cincinnati.
Cincinnati.
Do you remember at a time that whenever Cincinnati Men's Chorus was brought up, played a clip of Everybody Dance Now?
Pepsi Farm remembers.
Everybody Dance Now.
That was a while back.
Wow. Don't. Come on. Isn't
really a way to share sounds on here, is there?
Mm-hmm. No, you have to share the share screen.
Yeah, but I don't know if it shares the audio from what you're doing.
Might only work with sharing tabs.
Call 16 bears.
Reminded of a song called Bears.
Bears. I've never heard of that song.
Kendall song.
I gotta see if I can find it, because I'm pretty sure I have it loaded on my phone.
Imagine it just goes bears over and over.
Call 17 is cock.
Yep, I got some cock.
Need more.
Pixie Herculon is the artist, and they came up with an explicit song. I don't remember how old it is, called The Bear Song. I have it loaded on my phone.
That's not the song I'm referencing.
Yeah.
Ooh, it doesn't give me any details. Like, it doesn't tell me how old it is. I'll have to look it up. Call 18, Kink.
Never armed.
Negative.
No kink for me today.
Yep, only the ones in my back.
19, feedback. We've been doing this podcast too long because I was just imagining, hearing in my head the Janet Jackson riff that we play. Call number 20 is booty.
Booty?
B-O-O-T-Y, booty.
Like,
well, cock and booty are right next to each other, so that makes sense.
Well, unless it's garlic salt.
I don't think that made the list.
Garlic salted, one was bitty and the other was whole. And so it was like third squares in a row.
All right, so we got to just keep in mind we need to start talking about like garlic salted dishes. And talk a little bit about more holes for future reference.
David's like, I'm just going to do my drink. Call number 21 is Marvel.
Is what?
Marvel. Marvel. As in the comics.
No. Not Marvel, but Marvel.
I do have Disney.
Yeah. So. Not close enough.
Call 22 is YouTube.
Yep.
Call 23 is...
got Bing. I got 4 squares in a row, so it's Bing.
Call number 23 is CMC. I'm sensing a theme here, Damon.
I don't understand what you mean there. What are you insinuating, Gary?
I don't know. I can easily see who these tags are related to. Call 24, Disney. It is interesting how these words got put together on a bingo card. Call 25 is sex.
Sex.
You're getting a pretty full card. It's just nothing is ending up with a full bingo.
Really? I don't have that many.
Oh yeah, I'm one away from bingo on two different lines.
Same here.
I literally only have 6 out of the whole card. Call number 26, food.
I'm surprised I'm the only one eating.
No, I got some chips. I'm just not eating them.
Well, I appreciate you not, like, chomping away for the ASMR effect in the microphone that, you know. Number 27, yes. Live chat.
I think Mike is picking up cheering. It's a good thing. I really can't stand turn noises. It's just off my that one thing where like certain noises make you really uncontrollably angry as fuck.
Is that what, misophonic? Is that what it's called?
Something like that.
Something like that, yeah. Like
yeah. I am. Yeah. I just don't like chewing in people's, like, if we were sitting here and you were like chomping loudly in front of me, I would be like, shut the fuck up. I'm really annoyed. So I don't like to do it to others.
Right.
Especially since I'm mic'd. Like in addition, I'm microphone. I have a mic on me.
Mm-hmm.
Call 28 is Urban Dictionary.
Yes, Urban Dictionary. With Gary.
Call 29 is Facebook. Well, I wonder how far we're going to have to go before we get a bingo. This is interesting. Call 30 is music.
Music
makes the people come
together. Okay, so yeah. We get it.
Music makes the bourgeoisie and the rebel.
Yes, Madonna. Work it. Work it.
Call number 31, AJ.
Hey, AJ.
No.
Call 32, L-O-R.
Lore.
Which is landscape of relationships.
Lore.
Again, another reference to a last week's show.
Lord mm-hmm. of the Things.
Number 33 is Queen.
No. Okay.
I'm
now one away on three lines.
I'm beating you. I'm one away on four.
There's only 25 spaces on it, and you get one. So it's like the
technically,
odds are,
yeah.
The
yeah,
odds are getting hard. Crazy. Oh boy. Number 34 is monkeypox.
Oh.
No.
Yeah.
It's a dual pandemic. So.
Oh, you can't see it. I literally cannot turn my arm around. There we go.
You got your first intradermal dose?
Yep. Oop. There I go. Disappeared. There we go. Right there. Got my first one.
Number 35 is family.
Aww.
Our family.
Fair.
Thirty-six is D&D.
D&D. It's in D&D MIDI.
It's D&D.
Thirty-seven is Chester.
No.
We're going to have a multi-bingo in a moment. I can just tell. 38 is WBW for World Bear Weekend.
Nope.
No.
Thirty-nine is Final Fantasy. Nope.
Yeah.
Oh, dear.
Wow. 40 is LTAF. Let's talk about food.
Yeah.
Wow. This is like that, like slow cranking, like
you're edging off our food.
Yeah, I'm just not sure how popular that. Well, one of them I would expect probably said by now. The others I'm like maybe not as frequently said.
41 is prep.
No,
you're not saying anything that is currently available in my car.
Wow. 42. Sidekick Productions.
No.
Which is currently having a photo shoot in regards to their latest project.
Mm.
Which is one of the reasons why Joshua Pangborn is not here.
Ah.
He is 40, busy, but that's
43 is RuPaul.
No.
This is getting crazy.
See, this would have been perfect if we had stopped at 42.
Well, that's why I paused. I was like, maybe that's like fate. I don't know. 44, thickness.
Nope, not on my car.
Your mother, get up. Come on, get down with the thickness.
That's with two C's, right?
Yes. Two C's, two S's. 45 Cubs.
Anyone? Anyone?
Nope.
Bueller? Bueller.
I'm now. I have now two lines that can be pulled up.
Is COL.
Now, it would be really awesome if that was like the one that won.
Mother's get up, come on, get down with the thickness.
47 is COLDR.
Dun, dun, dun.
You've given three, which are related to one that would get me to win.
48 is pride.
Mm-hmm.
This is getting crazy.
Welcome to Big
Bang. I don't have 10 spaces left.
49 is Tony, aka Compass.
Okay, make that four lines.
I have five possible.
There's bound to have been a bingo by now.
And 50 is Hadrian.
Nope.
Wow. I'm looking at this card and I'm like, oh yeah, I have something that could potentially, if I hit it, it's a double. That's nice. Anyway.
Yeah.
51 is WGO for what's going on.
Okay. Five lines. Like, no, that makes it six, actually.
Fifty-two, critical role.
Bingo.
There you go.
So we got multiple bingos, as I figured we would.
Yes, I have multiple bingos.
Damon, what's your card number?
7007.
007, huh?
Yes.
This is so cool. I love this virtual game because it tells me exactly which ones you like, what matches. Like, it gives me a virtual card image. I don't think I can share this. I just think it's so cool looking. Is they not going to do it?
I think what's just funny is me and Owen had the same card.
Oh, really?
Jeff and I were playing the same card.
Oh, that's interesting that it gave you guys the same card in that case.
That's Jeff's card number there in the chat. Yeah, we were playing the same card.
Isn't that how it always is? Like, be random. Here's the cards. Get some random cards. Give four people the same two cards.
It also explains why nobody was getting bingo, because I was like, what is going on?
Okay, so we need to make sure that everybody has a different card this time.
Okay. So we're doing it again.
If you just click the link, it should randomize. Should.
Should.
I got double seven again.
I got the same card. Okay.
Oh, reset. God. Reset. Yes. Okay. Clear the card. That's fine. Close all this shit.
Yeah, he's
giving me the same card.
Just keeps giving
me the same card.
Really?
I want a different card.
Hold on. I'm going to do something fun and different. Come here, you. Let's go into Firefox.
Oh, wait. Hey. If you press help, and then it'll say that you can click a thing to get a new card.
Oh, yeah.
So I just got 014.
Damn it.
I got 11. I got card 11.
I got 022.
Okay, I'm getting a new card. Okay. 27. Nobody has 27, right?
Correct.
Okay.
Everyone has a different card. Hallelujah.
Who thought we would have to do that?
I'm literally in a whole other, like, app. I'm literally using Firefox for this.
All right, so call number one is Pride.
Okay.
No.
Call number two, Claw.
No. Okay.
Computer says no.
Call number three, Netflix.
No, you're just being a tease.
Call number four, Hadrian.
Oh, come on.
Call number five, feedback.
Just give me that feedback.
I got one.
Give me that sweet, sweet feedback. Just cover me.
Okay, call six, WGO. Call seven, CMC.
Turner, classic movies. Oh, wait, that's not what you said.
Not quite. Call number eight, drama.
My gosh! Drama. I'm about to start some drama if I don't get a word to. My gosh.
There's a lot of words. So.
75 of them, although we got pretty far through the list this last time. I was getting nervous. Call number nine, Star Wars.
I have Star Trek, damn it. Why?
Call number 10, LTAF.
Let's talk about fuck.
Yeah, that's LTAS.
Call number 11, WBW.
What a bad weekend.
Oh, which wait, there's one. I'll play one.
Which is coming soon.
Mm-hmm. All 12, All Stars.
Will always be an all-star.
All 13 Cubs.
No.
Call 14 Bob the Drag Queen.
Do you guys really talk about Bob the Drag Queen that much?
So I'm trying to think back when it was their season, and considering they made it all the way to the end, so they were on every single episode and won.
Then but they've also hosted.
Yeah, hosted like the pit stop a lot. And then
like two or three times, I think.
Yeah. And then I'm just trying to think what else they've did. They've done. Wow. I'm not even. Well, I guess it's half a bottle, so.
Call number 15, LOR. For landscape of relationships. Call 16, cock.
What?
Cock.
Cock.
Like cock.
Oh.
Penis.
Like chicken. Like the thing that gets smacked on your face. Call 17 podcast.
Oh, I wish. Wish. Stop teasing me. No, I don't help that either.
Call 18, music.
I don't see it. Stop teasing me. I just want a bit of edging. That's all.
Call 19, prep. Call 20, Facebook.
Oh, wait. Yeah.
Call 21, Twitter.
Which is our new Tumblr.
Twitter.
Call 22, AJ. Mm-mm. Call 23, chess.
Chess? What?
Mm-hmm. With one S.
Oh, chess. Chess. Oh, chess.
Call 24, queer.
There. Yes. They're coming in now.
Call 25, YouTube.
No, you just give it and they take it away.
I've heard that about him.
Really? Really? Call 26, STIs. And that is legitimately what came up. That was not even like shade being thrown back at you, you bitch.
Walk right into that one, right?
I was sitting there like, you've got to be kidding me. That was literally the next one. I love
call
it.
Call 27, COLDR. Call 28, thickness. With the
thickness. Mother, get up. Come on, get down with that thickness.
Like, can we talk about, before you get the, can we talk about, like, the thickness of some of these, like, toys that are out there now? Like, ma'am, no, that, no. I don't understand. Like, things like this stick around. Like, two handfuls holding.
Look.
Are you talking about sex toys?
Yes.
Okay.
Hey, some guys like that. No, they want those silicone injected dicks right up there.
It's just a lot.
Call 29 is Tumblr.
I see it.
Call 30 is kink. Womp womp. Anybody getting close?
I've got one, two. Yeah,
one more. That one left.
Are you going to conclude?
Call 31, monkeypox.
Now I have three.
That's not the words, but now I have two possibles.
So close to
call 32, drag race.
Bingo, I think.
You think?
Yeah, there's,
I mean, it's not hard.
Yes, there was, I anyway, just check the damn card. Number 14.
How could you be like, I think I have a bingo?
One that I hit that I thought I heard, but I could have been wrong. And that's why I'm
technically, yes, Drag Race was your was the completion of your top row.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, yay.
So we'll keep going and see who comes in next. Number 33 is COL. Number 34, Chester. Number 35, yeah. Leather.
Bingo.
Jeff. Jeff with a bingo.
Bingo, what's his name, Mo?
Bingo. All of the bingo.
So yours was the fourth column down?
Yep.
I really like this free bingo virtual game thing. It's like it's cool that it like shows me exactly what your card would look like.
Nice.
Neat, neat, neat.
All together. One neat little package.
So birthday boy, you have an option in front of you. Do you want to do trivia or do you want to do 15 yes and no questions?
Let's start with 15 yes or no questions.
Okay.
Ooh.
So these are purely 15 questions. The answer is either yes or no. It is not a maybe. It is not a eh or a in between kind of like I need more information. It is either yes or no.
So it is a this or that.
Correct.
Yes or no?
Well, you're answering a question, right? So you're making a decision, either yes or no. And Jeff, since it's your birthday, who do you want to go first?
I'll start.
Ooh.
All right. Number one, have you ever masturbated in the shower?
Yes.
And then if you want, we'll go round robin. Sure. What? Go ahead.
Sure.
Okay. Owen, I'm going in the order that you're on my screen. I don't know what everybody's screen order is. Same question.
Yeah.
I'm next. Mine's a guess. Eric?
Yeah.
Damon? Do we have a queen sweep?
Yes.
What's
What's with Gary, did you just say what's with the drama to me?
Yes, because you like put this pause in this dramatic pause, and I was like, you gotta think about this.
To me. Right. Damon, what's with the drama? I mean, it's literally you all the fucking time.
Number two. All right, Jeff. Do you like having your nipples touched?
No.
Okay.
And I'm saying that for a reason, but
okay, because you can't touch the words. Right. Owen?
You like to have your nipples touched.
Sexually, right?
Well, it doesn't technically say that.
Okay. Well, I'm going with
open, the open to interpretation.
I'm gonna say no. Gray?
No.
What? Yes. What is with y'all? Erogenous zone. Like,
well, so that's just
it. I said no. These are not attached to anything. These do not.
Yeah. I'm with Gray here. It's just mine. I mean, if somebody touches them and kind of plays with them, yeah, it's okay. But I mean, it's not something that's really going to get me off.
But it's just like, and I'm like, I appreciate the effort, but that does nothing.
That's nice. Cool.
What I will say is,
since there's a reason why you're on that poster and not us, okay?
Since the question was left up to interpretation, I said no because mine are actually really sensitive. And if, you know, somebody just comes up and starts doing that shit, I'm just like, no, don't.
That's
Yeah, that's like a a podcast I listened to recently, they were discussing about like past experiences and how they could, you know, not go well. And the one person said that they, the first time they ever had sex, the other person who was uncut was really into like being rough for sensitivity. And then the next time they were with an uncut person, they did the same thing because they were young and they didn't know. And then that person was like, get off me. Like, what are you doing? Like, it was a whole opposite reaction. And so the, their whole thing was they learned like, oh, not everybody likes the same thing.
I can
understand the super sensitive nipple thing, Owen. I had a I had a playmate who was very intent and said, do not play with my nipples, I do not like it, do not do it. So I was like, okay, cool. And then after we were done, I asked him why. And he was like, you, he's like, they are like super sensitive, like to the point where he has to wear like a couple of shirts sometimes. Wow. because they're just rubbing against him. And I don't think it was a connection per se thing. It was just, they're just always on.
Right.
Yeah.
It's kind of the reverse of what I have. Because, like, you can touch them, it just doesn't do anything for me.
I'm kind of in the same camp. Like, and what annoys me is I think some people think, like, they're not getting erections, so they need to go, like, harder. And I'm like, no, because now it's going to hurt. Like, that's not the point.
Like, me, you can, I mean, I'm not, I am, they are, they have some sensitivity, they are connected. For sure. But only to a point.
Mm-hmm.
Like I can take some, you know, damage. Just the word that came to mind. I didn't want to say that, but that's the word that came to mind.
Like biting.
Yeah. Depending. I've had some people get a little
scared. Next question, Jeff. Have you ever masturbated to the point that you got sore?
Yes.
Owen?
Yes.
I'm sure it's happened. I just...
Specifically... Mine is a yes. Yeah. Gray?
Yep.
No.
I am surprised, David. I was like, weren't we all teenagers once? Like, isn't that kind of when you're just like, I don't know, you push limits?
So welcome to Damon's world when he was a teenager. So for the first few years of my life, I lived in a repressed Christian household where if I got caught, it would be a problem.
Hmm.
Then I lived for 4 years with my sister and my mom. And while that like repression part wasn't there per se, the like always around, you know, women was always a little, was, yeah. And also like sexual desires were a lot repressed for several years, personally.
Right. No, I can understand that. All right, next question. Do you ever edge, which means to repeatedly stop and start, when masturbating?
I love Jeff's contemplative.
Yes.
He had, that was a thinker. Well,
because
for him.
I'm trying to get to a point of like, is this a yes or no? Because I'm like, okay, interpretations, possibilities. Yeah, I would say I consider that. Maybe not necessarily purposely, but I have.
Mm. Oh, what?
Yeah. It's just, you know, I want it to go on longer. So I'm just like,
I could understand that. Mine is a yes. Gray's in the affirmative. No. David?
No. I feel like, what's going on?
David's like, I'm in the Twilight Zone. What the hell is this?
Like, I oh gosh.
You're just on Nedrit, right?
Correct.
It's not quite your thing, right? It's fine. There's no shame in not it.
Wait. It's okay. Wait. But what was the question again?
Do you ever edge when masturbating? So it doesn't mean it has to be a regular practice.
Correct. That's there's the rub. So yes. The
answer. No pun intended.
But again, this is all based off of your interpretation of the question.
Yeah.
It's just a yes or no.
Yeah. I was
You were overthinking things.
I thought it was like a regularly edging or something along those lines. And no, but I have done it before.
Right. Yeah. Next question. Jeff, have you ever used a homemade sex toy or a regular object as a sex toy?
No.
Okay. Wait,
my answer.
What was the full question?
Have you ever used a homemade sex toy or a regular object as a sex toy?
So what I'm taking the question to mean, to kind of give
okay,
it
you interpret the question as it is, and you just answer yes or no to the question.
Right. Okay. I'm gonna go with yes, because I remember many times and many articles of clothing that I have done that. But so,
okay, mine is a yes.
Great. No,
Damon, are you muted?
Fuck yes.
Wait, yes for muted or yes to the question?
Yes to both.
Okay. So what was the question that you wanted to ask, like as a clarification or follow-up or the statement?
So my clarification was going to be, have you ever used something like an object, meaning like that people think like cucumbers and whatever, but also like have you used something as a masturbatory aid?
Well, like the way I thought of it is like flashlights are a thing, and what's comparable to flashlights? Socks, right? So,
yeah. So
I hate to keep referring back to like puberty and like being a teenager, but I'm like, I think people get real creative like with whatever they can make work.
It also interprets, like, am I actually using this as a sex toy, or is it just like, I like being touched there, so I have something here to make it feel like I'm touching
this toy,
that sort of thing. So, I mean, again, open up to the interpretation.
But, yeah, right. Like, I used to have, like, when I first learned masturbation for myself, the way I used to do it was basically humping things. So a bed, a couch, a cushion, a pillow, like that was the way.
Yeah, I've done that.
Yeah, so that was where my like the general start of it was, I guess. And then,
years later, he turned into a puppy.
A bitch.
Next question, Jeff. Do you like mild roughness? For example, scratching, spanking, hair pulling, etc.
Lock in your answers.
You're going to go with a no on that?
Okay. Owen?
So here's like, I haven't experienced a lot, but what I have experienced, I enjoyed. So I'm going to go with yes.
Okay. That's fair. I'm going to say yes. Gray?
Yeah.
Damon.
Yes.
Damon's giving the side eye look like, why are we even asking this question of me?
Yeah, because we all know Damon's.
Yeah, we're all like, surprise, surprise.
Sorry. So to go to battle.
Well, and so, like, I pulled a lot of these questions off the internet, off of, like, I think about four different websites of, like, you know, not Cosmo, but, like, these random sexy kind of question things you can do with your partner. But I like the fact that a lot of these questions, they're meant to be yes, no, but they, no matter what, you kind of think you're like, well, mm-hmm. like, depending on the person, the situation, and all that. So, yeah. Mm-hmm. Jeff, number 7. Have you ever had any genital injuries?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Owen?
I think a lot of people should know, yes, I have. I will call that an injury.
Okay. Owen's thinking.
I'm going to go with no, because
okay.
I don't know what really... What really that means. I don't know what you would consider like a serious injury or like just like, you know, some minor where it gave you a scab on your dick or something. I don't know. But yeah.
Okay. We'll get into the discussion in a moment. For me, it's a yes. Gray?
I'm going to say no to this one.
Okay. David?
Reasons?
Oh, gosh. So, I hate to say this, but repeat the question again.
Have you ever had any genital injuries?
No.
Okay. So now I'll help explain. Mine is a guess because I cut myself shaving.
Yeah.
Mine is a note that had things happen, but they're not really injuries per se.
Yeah. So like,
I graced myself shaving
because of the whole monkeypox thing. Oh. When I was a kid and got chickenpox, I got one that got infected and ruptured in the space between the back of the head and the top of the shaft. So that was,
oh wow.
Yeah. Yeah, and of course I was a good Catholic boy, so I could not discuss it with anyone. So I suffered through that in silence.
Oh,
wow.
Yeah.
See, I'm counting the fact of waking up one day when I was 14 years old and something got a little twisted.
That's right.
Yes. That's why I only have one.
Yeah. See,
that's why I'm like injury.
Yeah. A couple of years ago, I got, and then like I said, I'm also not counting this. This is not really an injury per se. A couple of years ago, I got diagnosed with a tendency towards varicoceles, which are varicose veins in your scrotum. But it's really fun. I wonder what they feel like. They feel like everything you've ever been told to look for during a self exam.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yep. So imagine finding this and, of course, having the immediate, oh shit, heart attack moment.
Interesting. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I've heard of those before.
Yeah. When I was in the ER this week, that's literally the first time I've been in Hammett as a patient where I didn't have to take my pants off.
I feel like you deserve a ribbon or an award for that, but anyway.
Well, because yeah. I had the of course, the ultrasound associated with all of that. That was done in the hospital building. And also a few years ago, I had to have a nerve conduction study of my right leg. And that was done in the hospital. Really fun part is when they shove the giant needle probe into your thigh.
Yeah. No, thank you. The
And it makes noise.
Yeah. Yeah. So for me, the main thing was injury is that it was an accident and not intentional.
That's fair. I mean, I could see how you would draw the line and say, you know, whether intention was there or not, because you could technically, well, no, I guess not. Like, you could unintendedly have an injury, I guess is the whole point.
Mm-hmm.
Which makes it an accident. Anyways. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, I unintentionally had my head testicular torsion. I did not intend to have that.
Yeah, so right. That's why I'm thinking in critical injury. That's where the injury lies.
Right. All right. Number 8, Jeff, do you care if a partner sees you going to the bathroom?
No.
Owen?
No.
I don't care. Asterisk. Gray.
It's yes or no, Gary. Follow the rules of your own game, I mean, Gary.
See, I have asterisks in mind. I just didn't say it.
See, I'm not the only one.
A lot of these end up being with an asterisk.
So mine is no, because I've had a partner for almost 20 years. So if we can't get comfortable taking, you know, doing that stuff, then it's a little late.
So, okay, I don't care if a partner sees me going to the bathroom. But the reason why I have an asterisk is if my lower GI tract is unhappy, I really don't think my partner wants to be around for that. I would prefer them to not be around for that. So that's kind of where I'm coming from. Like just as a politeness kind of thing.
Okay.
I'm not shy. I'm really not. You know.
Everybody poops.
Although
it's the poop where it sometimes gets the pooping where it gets a little iffy. But you know, like, check if we're both need to pee, we can both pee at the same time. So that's not gonna be a big deal.
Like here's the thing, if it's around somebody I'm not really on close terms with, then yeah, I would feel a little uncomfortable. But yeah, it's just like around, like, you know, partner, like a friend that I'm really close to or something like that. It's just like, never, you know. I'm sure we know each other's ritual bathroom habits, and like if he didn't want to see me squatting on the toilet, then he would go into the other room or something. And I generally close the door anyway, so.
Right. I mean, like, to be fair, if I have anybody over, like, that's visiting or staying, like, I don't leave my bathroom door open. I just think that's a politeness issue.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Next question. Number 9. Jeff, can a dildo feel as good as a penis?
Yes.
Owen?
No. Personally, I'm going to say no.
I'm going to say no.
I have absolutely no idea.
That's fair. David?
I need a second.
Well, we broke David.
I have absolutely no idea. Yes.
Okay. So the reason why I let Gray say that is because I just realized that that question makes a presumption that you've had that experience. So, yeah.
Well, no. So I, well, No, I have not had that personally. I have been fucked before, but I've not had a dildo.
Right. Yeah, neither have I.
Having said that, know. Though,
I mean, do I would I prefer it? No, but
if you were like in a moment where
I like the real thing to begin with,
when you if you want like to be penetrated and there is no real dick to be found, I bet that dildo is going to look really good and feel really good. Just saying.
Yeah, kind of like it can. Mm-hmm. Is it? Maybe not, but it can.
What I want to say is, for me, there's like more connotations to it because I fit into the realm of both being a demisexual and a side. So for me, it's a very emotional experience. So I don't think I'm going to have an emotional attachment to it, though.
Right. Fair.
No, and I think that is fair. But you know, there's always a possibility. You never know. So sticking with the dildo theme, Jeff, would you ever have a dildo made of your penis? Y'all, if you could see the nonverbals from Damon's cam during this session. Sorry. It is a journey.
I mean, it's a yes or no question, so I'm going to say yes.
Okay.
Asterisk.
Owen?
Yes.
I'm going to say no. Gray?
Yes.
Damon?
No.
Okay. So this is going to sound really personal. I'm going to say no because I'm going to be like, either you get it when it's live or you just don't get it.
No, you're never going to get
it. I mean, yeah. Well, mine is like, am I ever going to do that? No. But, you know, somebody wanted it and they were like,
you know what? Somebody often wants me to make a dildo of my penis.
I'm not going to be for it.
Then, yeah, I would do it.
Yeah, it depends on
the other hand, if I was going to give my boyfriend some, I would definitely make a dildo of my penis and give it to him.
See, this is kind of what I thought these questions were going to do. There was going to be these like discussions about like, you know, possible scenarios and all that kind of stuff.
I do not have the time, energy, or patience to wait, 5-10 minutes, however long it takes for this thing to cure so that you can take the mold to do the penis thing. I'm just saying, like,
you can, like, I'm not patient, forget it.
You can either get it.
It's like the idea, sure, but I don't have the patience for like quote unquote like posing.
Yeah, it's like no, no, I ain't got time for that.
All right, next question.
Sure someone would want it, but.
And this is going to probably be a speed round. Jeff, do you have naked pictures or videos of yourself online?
Yes.
Owen?
Yes.
Yes. Gray?
Yes.
I knew there was going to be a speed round. I was like, I don't know if sure why I put the picture or put the question in to begin with.
Maybe because you wanted something. You
were generally gay men in the 21st century.
I know.
I know. Yeah, I think Twitter.
Gary,
like
did you answer?
Time
I did. I said really yes.
Put myself up there.
Yeah, Gary had some risque pictures on his Tumblr at one point. What? Mm. What? What?
Oh, I guess what? I did post those on there.
Yes, you did.
That was so many years ago. I'm like, did I? Oh, I guess I did. Yeah, I was having a moment. Anyways, next question. Jeff, have you ever had your prostate stimulated?
Yes.
Owen?
Yes.
No.
Oh. Yes.
David.
Sorry, I'm...
Answer the question first.
Yes.
Okay. Now, the reason why I'm laughing is because Owen's response when I said no.
Well, no. I'm
was so, like, empathetically sad. Like, oh. Like,
just so bad for bad you. I feel bad because you're missing out.
Oh, my God. I'm going to cry. And I can tell David's laughing, and I think it's the same thing. I was like, wow.
No, I was. It was that, and it was also like, really? You haven't? I go, oh, okay.
Also, open up to interpretation, yeah, because what do you mean by prostate stimulated? Does that mean using a prostate stimulator, or does that mean just being stimulated by any means necessary?
So I'm just going to say we had an episode a while back where we mentioned things from the Hush line, and somebody went and bought some things and has used them.
Oh.
And has quite enjoyed said things.
So do we need to revisit this as a topic and get, and have like a discussion about the rating of the experience?
You know what? I just realized something. My first boyfriend was the only person who ever actually fucked me hard enough to stimulate my prostate.
Yeah. Also fair and true.
Is for me, one of the ways you manage the whole varicose thing is occasionally making sure that everything like completely empties out. But you know, it kind of goes with the fact that I don't, the question about the dildo versus the penis, it's not like it's an enjoyable thing. It does achieve that.
Yours is more clinical.
It feels very mechanical.
Yours is clinical. Like,
yeah, it's
I need to insert something A into slot B so that
I'm getting off, I'm enjoying that, but there's no like
the way you explain that makes me think you're talking about a video game console. Play your one, please insert your thing into slot B.
Okay, I'll stop so we don't get demonetized. On
you my player too?
Sometimes slot C.
What do you mean be demonetized?
You have to be monetized to be demonetized. Anyways,
yeah.
Number 13, Jeff, do you ever go commando?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, for me.
Yes. Sorry, invader.
Aw, kitty.
Zin?
Yes. But not all anymore. Of us,
yes.
You're going to be famous, Scream.
Number 14.
Highest views on this fucker.
Number 14, Jeff. Does your penis curve at all?
Yes.
Owen?
Yes?
No.
Nope.
Yes.
Interesting. Only interesting because I think when we're young, if you don't have a lot of experience, by experience I mean like, I guess visual reference, you may not know that genitalia comes in all sorts of shapes and sizes, and mm-hmm. like and that there are some that have a curvature, whether it be up, down, or to the side, mm-hmm. or at an angle, or whatever the case may be.
Yeah.
All right, last question, Jeff. Have you ever been to a nude beach, naked party, or other situation involving casual nudity?
Yes.
Owen?
Yes.
Yes, for me.
Yeah.
Yes. I was like, Gary, of course you have. You literally work someplace. For...
I knew you were going to say that. I knew you were going to be like, bitch, you better say yes. You worked at a clothing optional gay campground. Like, how could you not say yes?
I keep completely blanking out that I actually worked at the bathhouse at one time. So.
Yeah,
it's probably repressed memories, given the stories friends of mine who have worked at them have told.
Yeah, casual. Yeah. Casual. I love that it's like quote unquote casual nudity. Like,
That's why I like the question. I thought it was interesting. It says, or other situation involving casual nudity, which helps define naked party and nude beach. As opposed to like sex beach or orgy, it was helping differentiate that this is the not necessarily that. Now, I mean, it could lead to that, but that's another issue.
Have you been to a pool party where people got naked and suddenly had sex?
Mm-hmm.
I have not. Well, wait.
Well, figuring that out since we got through the game. I have been summoned for dinner. Happy birthday, Jeff. Good night, folks.
Good night, Greg. Have a good night. Well, he's gone. Oh, God. Maybe it was. I don't think it was. I don't think it was a... I remember being like a get-together in a pool, in a being a pool, and it being a pool party, but I don't recall people actually having sex.
I have been to a couple of pool parties in which I was amused by the fact that the owner got mad that people had sex in the pool. It would be like, you could have sex anywhere you want outside of the pool, just not in the pool.
Wow.
Because, of course, they had to clean it. Like, you know, they were like...
Please have sex anywhere but here.
Like, well, not anywhere.
Well, you know.
And the reason I say that is because I just remember there was also an incident that someone like hogged up the bathroom for a while. And the host was annoyed with that.
That is a good question, a good statement for a potential topic. We've had etiquette questions before, etiquette like at bathhouses and what have you. There is, I like to think there is sex party etiquette.
Interesting, because I do have written for LTAK about play space etiquette, but this is distinctly different. This is, So let me, I'm writing this out, David. You're hearing it here first, kids. So for this sex etiquette, is it like sex party etiquette? Is that what we're thinking?
Like sex party, playroom, if you're at a bear event, for example, or you're at someone's home and they are hosting a event of this kind, or like when we had the question about like casual nudity, I've been to nudist events where they specifically have designated spaces where here is where we're just like, while we're naked, we are just like socializing. We're just, you know, here's the food over here. We're socializing, whatever. If you wanted to play, you can play either in this room or upstairs or over here, but like this general area here is essentially no play. You can talk, you can flirt, but if that flirting is going to a certain point, you got to take your ass upstairs or take your ass to the playroom.
No, that makes sense.
Right.
All right, so this will be interesting for trivia because I'm curious to know how many of my co-hosts with Owen actually know these answers.
Oh, dun, dun, dun.
Because these trivia questions are all about Cubs Out Loud, specifically.
Okay.
Question
number... Owen, we're going to find out how much of a super fan you are.
Maybe.
Oh, gosh.
Oh, you're fine. Don't worry about it.
Yeah.
No one's getting tested or graded. This is totally casual.
Yeah. Question number one, what year did COL launch?
Are you giving us any options?
Mm-mm.
Okay, of course not. Oh, God.
I know the answer.
In the time of dinosaurs, right?
No, much, much, much later than that.
I want to say... Hold on.
No searching.
I'm not searching. My hands are down here. Here. I'll actually even do this. I'll make it even easier so no one look at it. Hands up.
Although I'm currently second guessing myself, but I think I'm correct. I will either get it right on or right or be a year off.
I want to say 2007.
Oh, and
but I feel like that's wrong.
Do you have a guess? You don't have to. And no cheating by going online and looking.
Oh, you caught me.
Well, it's kind of easy because the screen like brightness keeps changing in front of your face.
And you didn't put your hands up.
It's all right. And Jeff, what is your guess?
2009. Again, I could be either right on or year off. I think Damon and I could be either way, but I'm pretty sure it was not 2007.
It's actually in between both you and Damon.
2008.
Yes. January of
2008.
Ah. I thought that was interesting that you both bookended it. And I was like, wow, okay.
Yeah, I was thinking 2009, but I'm like, where was it? 2008?
Yeah, and I was...
I moved down in 2006. Carl died October 2007. So the earliest I could have started would have been 2008, but I thought there was an additional year there. But
yeah.
Okay.
And I went backwards. So,
David, when did you join as a co-host? That's the second question.
How accurate? How accurate are you looking for here?
A month and a year is fine.
I'm crossing my
God. Arms. Oh God. I think I can give you a year. Wait.
Okay, go ahead.
2012.
Correct. Yeah. Do you remember what month by chance?
March or May?
You're correct, March.
March. I was gonna say March too.
Yeah.
Because I was
and then go ahead.
Well, because I was, again, when I was doing the first question, I'm writing a note here. I was doing the math and I realized like recently we did the 10-year anniversary.
Jeff's holding up his Comes Out Loud to Patreon 10-year anniversary shirt on purpose. Because it is 2012 on it, anyways.
Right there.
That's why I immediately just went crossed my arms.
Now I know why you crossed your arms, because you said out loud, I'm going to cross my arms. And I was like, okay, so that's fine. You're not using the internet. Never mind. Now I get
yeah.
Now my, just the week, yeah. The day, the hour, the minute, and second.
No.
I remember. I was trying to remember because it was like, oh yeah, it was 10 years ago because we just celebrated 10 years, and I was like, okay, cool. So back your and when I was going backwards, I was trying to think. So how long ago? And I remembered that you took about a year or so off between the end of your show and mine,
the original series.
Yeah, the original series and the TNG. And I was like, okay. So when did that go? And you were doing it for a few years. So that's why I went to 2007. I was like, oh, maybe, but I thought that may have been too far. So I was right. I was too far by a year.
All right. And then when did I join as a co-host?
Is that October of the same year?
Mm-mm. It was
2013. And then right after Drench Fur. Or was it right before?
It was after Drench Fur. It
was 2013.
Uh-huh. And it was
January.
It was January 2013?
Because I was a guest to talk about Drench Fur. And then you guys revealed to me that was kind of my audition. Because someone, Damon, had reached out to me and was like, you might be interested. We're looking to maybe bring on another co-host. And so I had reached out. And then lo and behold, the episode that I was in was kind of the beginning.
It was a screen test.
There you go. All right, question number four. How many Cubs Out Loud pedestal members have there been to date?
Ooh. Ooh.
I'm going to say...
This is probably mostly a guessing game for...
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, that's pretty much it.
10.
Okay.
I'm gonna say 13. I don't know why that number specifically. That's just what comes in my head.
You and I are on the same wavelength then, because I was going to say 13 also.
Gary?
Hang on. I have the answer, but now I'm recounting.
Uh-oh.
Yes, 15.
Oh, 15. Oh. Wow.
But 13 is a good guess because there are 13 pictures on the website.
Oh.
Because there's two couples, I think, if I remember correctly. Uh-oh, or at least there's one. There's
I think we had Chess and...
have Chess and Perrin in one.
Oh, that's right.
Maybe there's only one. That's a couple.
Hold on. I'm looking at it now. Eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Yeah, there's 15.
Okay. But there's only one couple pictures. So that would be 14.
Yeah. Yeah. So if you look at the site, I am cheating. Ha ha ha. So there are four rows of three pictures. But of those four rows, one of them is the duel with Chess and Perrin. Mm-hmm. And then at the very top are two pictures. And
right. Yeah.
And not to get so if there's another question about pedestal, I will abstain from answering because I literally
just... No, it's okay. the next one is how many retired hosts of Cubs Out Loud are there?
Five, six, seven.
Very good, Jeff. So here's the funny thing. David and I were discussing this just this past week. We were trying to figure out who all was a retired co-host. And we were naming them and trying to get them all right. And it was really funny to me because I was like, Jeff's the only one that knows with any certainty.
Yeah. Because I was going through like mentally, and I was like, I remember most of the ones from TNG on, but I didn't know the first edition. We'll do first edition. That sounds really good.
Original series.
There you go.
Let's stick with the Star Trek.
Let's stick with Star Trek reference. Got it. So,
JJ, Tim Cub, and John, aka Kudzu Cub, were TOS.
No. JJ, aka John, aka Kudzu Cub, was one person. Tim Cub.
Oh.
Griff. He's Griffin.
Okay.
And then we had Ben, Eric. Why can't I think of his name?
Used to live in California, now lives in Chicago.
Want to say Robert. I knew it was an R. And then Chester.
Correct. I didn't know that JJ, aka John, aka Katsuko, like that was all one person. That was where David and I think where we were talking and we couldn't figure out the right like nickname for the name and all that stuff. All right, how many unique episodes of the Cubs Out Loud main series have been recorded to date?
Well, this is episode 662. So just throwing that out there. So you can technically say You can start with 662 and go up.
Can you?
I would think so.
I feel shame because I have no idea what episode was the last one. So I'm just like,
if you're counting the next generation.
Well, yeah. So
the beta, alpha, whatever I called it.
Right. So the reason why I called it unique episodes is because if it doesn't, it's not a flashback.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And I said main series, so we're not including random acts of cubbiness or special episodes or mm-hmm. COL movies or COL Drag Race or Cubs Out Loud TV. Like, there's all these things that we've done. And I'm not going to say how many, but there have been patron-only episodes.
A scandal.
So David's not correct to look at the number and be like, okay, well, this is 662, so that seems like a good starting point. Jeff brings up an excellent point, because there were six pre-TNG like shows mm-hmm. that are not technically numbered, if I remember correctly.
Yeah, because I picked up the numbering after after a certain point in time. Where I'm like, yes. Okay, we can get on the next generation line.
And lo and behold, in my research, there are four random episodes that we have numbers for and a zero history. There is no evidence of a recording that was lost or documentation. It just looks like a skipped week. And yet there was a number listed in the sequencing.
Wow.
This was in the TOS. It's kind of comical because it took me a while to piece that together, because I was like looking at the website, I was looking at our spreadsheet, and I was like, wait, did we seriously just skip a week but then counted it as a number? Like, now, if you wanted to account for, so anyways, the answer is 664. Because you take away the four that don't exist but were numbered, and the six that are pre-TNG, that gets a 664. But the question is, how many is the grand total of everything?
Oh, wow.
It's got to be well over 700.
It is over 700.
800?
It is over 800.
900?
It is over 900.
1,000?
No.
Okay. So we're somewhere between 900 and 1,000. So I'm going to look at a calculator.
Okay.
This is how Damon does things.
We're at 662 right now. There's 140 some of Drag Race.
I'm going to say 952. Just throwing a random number out.
Are you sure it's not being
I am counting COL TV episodes, random acts of cubbiness, special episodes, of which there are two different types in the labeling. I don't know why. The COL movies, the COL Drag Race, and the patrons only episodes.
You know what? Not 86. I'm just going to put that out there right now.
942. Are we doing, what type of rules are we doing on this? Is this like Price is Right rules? Close without going over.
Well, this is what's interesting, because now I'm trying to write them down really quick to see who got the closest.
So I was 952.
I'm 942.
And then when you had 96.
To be fair, mine is a semi meme answer.
That's true. Owen came the closest.
Really?
Yes. The answer is 972.
Oh. I was off only by 20. Nice.
Yeah. Jeff was off by 30. Damon was off by 20. And Owen was just over by 14.
Yeah, and mine was kind of a meme answer because I did 42.
But that's actually a really good guess. I didn't realize we were creeping up on 1,000 for COL Media overall.
Which, by the way, that's what I refer to everything all connected to COL Media.
Right. The universe.
The COL multiverse.
How many flashback episodes have there been to date? This is probably mostly a guess for everybody.
16.
10.
I'm going to say...
You haven't done that many, I don't think.
I'm going to say 20.
Owen was exactly right.
Was 16?
Yes.
Wow. Nice.
I was about to say right away that he was right, and then Jeff chimed in, and I was like, okay, I'm just going to shut up. Everybody answer.
Let us guess. Good job. Good job, Owen. That's
that's like 2 for 2, isn't it?
Yes. How many weeks of regular recordings have been skipped in Cubs Out Loud? Now, there is a little caveat. We are not counting the downtime between May of 2011 to March of 2012 when the from TOS to TNG. So that's not counted.
We're saying how many, sorry, repeat the question.
How many weeks of regular recordings have been skipped?
It's got to be like 24.
I'm going to say 27.
It's got to be a good chunk. But I don't think we've hit a full year of weeks skipped.
You have a guess, Owen?
There was a time I did kind of like go with monthly where it was going to be specifically near the end of the original series. So.
Well, I was just going to go 27 because, like, I mean, you already have the 16 of flashback episodes, and then I don't know what else was done there, so.
All right, and let me recall, Jeff, what did you say yours was?
24.
Damon?
So kind of flip. I said 27, like Owen.
You are all over.
Oh, wow.
Not that much. Okay.
No.
Is it 20?
Less than
12?
Less than 20.
18.
Huh. Mm-mm. Jeff was so hot.
13.
Yes. Officially over the time when we recorded, when we've made recordings, we've only missed just roughly over 3 months total, like for 13 weeks.
Wow.
When did COL launch the Patreon?
I was here for that, but I have no idea also. So
2017.
No, not that long ago. I think it's been, was it April? That
was 2019? Post-pandemic, wasn't it?
It was pre-pandemic.
I would say it was April 2019.
I'm just giving 2017. You can have the whole year. But I'm saying 2017.
I'm going to say 2021. I have no idea, but I want to say it's post-pandemic. So.
It was March of 2018.
Oh.
It was a year and a month off. That was April that we started, but I wanted to actually say March, but I was like, no, I think we announced it in March, but it actually launched in April or something.
Yeah. So next year it'll be 5 years.
Wow.
It was next year. That's 5 years.
Yeah.
Why did I think it was this year?
That's okay. So how many guests have there been total? Guests count as unique individual persons, not repeats.
Unique? Oh, geez. This has got to be a lot.
It is more than a single digit. I'll give you that.
34. I'm really just giving a random number. Because there was a bunch in the first series, too.
I'm going to say
34.
I'm going to say 38.
23.
You guys are all very low.
Oh, wow.
42?
Higher.
52.
Wait, it's funny. I was going to say 42.
And I don't think it's around zero.
I will give you this. It is not three digits.
Okay, cool.
87.
Very close.
88.
No.
89.
Too high.
86.
81.
85.
84.
Yes, 84.
Wow.
Jesus,
that's recording TOS and TNG forward without counting them as repeats. I did a project several years ago, and you two as co-hosts should be able to see it. I can't remember where I have it hidden. It's a spreadsheet, and I was literally capturing and tracking how many times we've had a guest and how many times they've been a repeat. Because that leads us to the second part of this, which is who holds the highest record total for guest spots on Cubs Out Loud? And as a bonus, how many times have they been on?
Wow.
I'm going to say it's either Hadrian or Edward as of now.
Owen gets all the points. Huh? Because Hadrian is the top rated and Dr. Edward Angelini Cook is in second place.
Wow. Look at that. Wow. I was just thinking, in my head, I was like, well, we've had Ed on a lot.
Mm-hmm.
Lately, at least. Yeah.
Yeah, but lately. Yeah. And that's why I was kind of like, okay, yeah, he's been on.
He's become a
regular.
Much more of a reoccurring guest lately.
Yeah. Right. But on the flip of that, I was like, but we had, whenever we were doing a Let's Talk About Sex episode, especially in the beginnings, it was like, Hadrian. Come on, be on our show because we think you're sexy and we're talking about sex and you tend to like know a lot about sex because, you know.
Yeah.
I'm going to say 24 episodes for Hadrian.
So half of, or not half, woo. Wrong. Math is hard. Oh, gosh.
18.
I'm going to say more than 30.
Damon is the closest for Hadrian.
Okay.
42.
No. I'll just say that, Damon, you're off by one. It's 31.
Ah.
For Hadrian. And Jeff, you are so close on Edward.
23? Oh.
22. Going the wrong direction.
25.
Yes.
Okay.
As of this past week, it was 25 episodes with Edward.
Ah.
So as relevant as it is today, because it's a birthday celebration, how many times has COL hosted a Power Hour episode?
I want to say 6.
Yeah, 6.
7.
Total is 8.
Damn it. I forgot one.
Because we did have some before we were doing birthday bash power hours.
That's right.
I must confess, I might have been watching them in my free time, so.
That's fine. I might not remember some of them.
Well, here's the next question. How many times has a COL host not finished a Power Hour episode?
A majority. I mean, you would probably have a smaller number of how many times they have.
I know I've tapped out at least twice. Well, if not
that's
multiple
eight
times.
For Dave.
Really?
I'm pretty sure.
Okay.
I'm sure he tapped out like every single time or didn't even participate.
If I participated at all, I know like there was the very first one. I made it through, but the second one I didn't. And I know that for a fact. And then there was another one that I did. I recall not making it through.
So I only, from my memory, I did not go back and watch all of them. I had twice. I had Jeff once and Damon once.
Ah.
But.
So maybe I'm forgetting one.
Well.
I mean, not forgetting one, but like.
Like there may have been one early on for you, Damon. But I infamously remember the second one. Because you disappeared to the bathroom for a while.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what I remember is both times. Actually, Jeff did it as well. Like Jeff just kind of went off cam and we didn't hear from him for a while because he went to the bathroom.
Yeah.
Mm.
But these are years
ago.
Yeah,
but to be fair, like one time when Jeff fell down and we were all worried about him. And
that was after the show too. That was after we went off on.
Well, so
yeah, I was sitting on the floor laughing my ass off talking about my mom.
Let's go to that question. How many times has a COL host disappeared for an episode?
Four, five.
I would say that's about it.
Wow, I only had twice, and I don't. And this is me guessing. This is once was Jeff during his birthday off cam, sat on the floor and talked to his mom on the phone during the birthday show, and made Damon and Gary very nervous because we thought he passed.
That was after the show. That was after the show.
Understood. Okay. Still.
I guess that technically doesn't count as during an episode, but still.
Technically, it would be three because there was actually a original series episode, which I'm not sure if we have a audio for, where I got very upset and just left.
So seven, I guess.
And then there was once that I slept through.
Oh
yeah, that's right. Which was also last year's birthday.
Happy birthday, Jeff.
Yeah.
Oh, and Damon wasn't even there.
I wasn't even there. But you knew I wasn't there. You knew I wasn't going to be there.
Yours was intended, so right. You didn't disappear.
Yeah. Correct. Yes. Mine. So that's why I only had twice because it was the only times I knew of that we basically missed somehow or something happened. That's why I phrase it as disappeared, because like it was unintended, so to speak. And then last but not least, how old are the current hosts of Comes Out Loud?
Shit. I would know this if I was following from Less Power Hour, but I don't know.
I know at least two. I'm trying to remember how much older you are, Gary, than Stephen and I.
So I can say it if I remember, but I could be remembering wrong. Oh God, am I remembering wrong?
Because I think Damon and I think have crossover of age for like a month or two. You're in October, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I'm not even gonna guess because I feel rude for guessing. So
it's okay. Well, so technically,
I mean, can you guess how old I'm going to be?
Well, I was just gonna say technically Jeff hasn't turned his birthday age yet. He doesn't in 2 days.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah.
And I've been memeing my soon-to-be age all through the show.
Right.
Well, So as of today, Jeff is 41.
Mm-hmm. I am 42. I'm going to say Gary is 47.
No. David, what's going on your end? I feel like Tim's chiming in and saying
shit. I have a peanut gallery in the living room.
What did the peanut gallery say?
Oh, now we took the headset off. Like, we know it's serious.
He said I'm vintage, but that wasn't the first thing he said.
Oh.
He said you old.
About that wedding. Okay. Anyway,
I think right now, to me, the I can't remember mystery is scary. Because I can never remember how much older he is than Damon and I.
But if you think about my online nickname, you would know.
Oh, wait a minute. Hold on. Hold on. You're definitely younger than my brother, older than my sister. Matt's. Have you had your birthday this year?
No.
No. He's okay. A Scorpio like me.
Okay. So 48.
Correct.
Yeah.
Mm. We're in a row. Jeff is in August. Damon's in October. I'm in November.
Right.
So there's only a... I mean, I'm like 2 days away from September, so otherwise it's a little bit.
So. Yeah, I forgot though about the overlap. I don't know if I want to call it overlap, but that for a brief period of time, you, Jeff, and Damon both are the same age number for a couple of weeks.
Mm-hmm.
For over a month.
Yeah.
Because all of September, we're the same age.
And most of October.
Yeah. Most of October, though.
Yeah. So yeah, so that was a little bit of a trivia about the podcast overall and snapshot, like as we go down memory lane of the running of the numbers. The thing that took me a bit, honestly, was tracking and then remembering and finding all the different variables of the shows over the years and how many there were. So I don't know what happened, just as like as a random comment. We had 11 special episodes. Three of them are with SEC as like the abbreviation, I guess, or whatever you want to call it. And then eight of them have SP. And I have no idea why we didn't carry forward one or whatever. But it cracks
me up. You know which one started?
Yeah, I think I did special edition and then I did special edition for SE and then SP for special episode or something like that.
Yeah.
So
it's not a big deal, but it just kind of cracked me up. I was like, wow, okay.
I don't know why I was thinking.
And then honestly, I forgot about the five patron only episodes.
Special penis.
Now, the reason why the Patreon one actually comes to mind is because we may have had a new person join Patreon at the highest level.
Ooh.
And so they are getting us that much closer to one of our reward levels.
Yay.
If we reach the goal, then we have a bi-monthly hangout.
Ah.
Where the patrons and the hosts will have a kind of a, well, I don't want to say one-to-one. I don't know what the three to whatever. Like a special episode.
Nice.
So I just happened to come across, I was updating some information, and then on the Patreon I saw that we're closing in on the goal for that. So
nice.
Yay. Thank you, patrons.
So yeah. Anything, words of wisdom, thoughts, ideas as we get to wrapping up, Jeff, here for your birthday?
Make sure you actually talk to your apartment manager about your air conditioning and you'll actually get it fixed. Instead of putting the work order on the app, like you think would be the thing that would fix your things, but apparently not. I have to actually talk to somebody.
I take it you actually talked to them and now it's fixed?
Yeah, I got air conditioning now.
And we don't hear it.
Well, it's because of noise suppression.
Well, we used to be able to hear it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it actually isn't as bad. It's still kind of loud, but I mean, not as bad as it used to be.
Nice.
Well.
So it just goes to show everybody, over a decade plus of putting on a podcast, you can get equipment upgrades and make changes.
Sometimes you got to do shit in person.
That's fair.
And for someone who doesn't like talking to people, it's really weird that he has a podcast.
Right.
I think, but I don't know, at this point, are we pretty much the longest standing bear podcast?
That's a good question.
I'm not sure. Really, what was the last about bear podcast episode?
Oh.
That might be an offline review.
They went to 600. Bear podcast with Ray and Nard, they went to 600. That was their final episode. And they still have their website up.
Yeah.
Yay.
Bear podcast also didn't start with Nard, but with Ray. It was Nard for a while there only, and then rejoined on as a co-host.
Right.
You know what I find amazing is that you're all at the same coffee shop, but in different seasons. Yeah. And I'm just in my room.
And actually, I don't think we're at the same... Wait, hold on.
I mean, we could be. I mean, it's just, you know, different things on the counter behind us.
Well, Damon's there in the summer, and Gary's there in the winter.
I mean, I'm still summer, just rainy.
Well, it could be fall. You could have, like, fall. Or spring showers.
I suppose not as many leaves on the trees. Trees behind me.
And I keep forgetting that, like,
yeah,
as I'm looking at my video, like, I was about to say, well, I'm technically in a whole other corner, but no, I'm not, because my video is flipped,
reversed, right?
Yeah,
I was thinking that myself. I was like, oh no, I'm in a different, but then I was like, no, because my building has five windows and Damon's building has five windows, and I think Jeff's does, but I just can't quite see because of his chair. As he like wheels himself out of
place. As he moves, tries to move to show all the windows.
Yeah, there 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I think this is meant to be the same, like,
cafe,
quote unquote.
It's different time to be. Like, mine has flowers on the windowsill because it's summer and sunny, and then,
maybe we can go under the sea.
No, he's under the sea. That's nice.
Under the sea.
Oh my gosh, Sebastian.
Well.
But now I'm in space.
Or when you
decide to go to the beach.
There's anything else?
It's a classroom of some sort. There's a pencil and an apple.
Oh my gosh, you have scented fruits behind you. How do you feel about that?
I don't know. My microphone's falling off.
Uh oh.
There we go. There you go. I got it fixed. This is what happens when you put a microphone on a particle board desk.
Mm-hmm.
Or microphone arm thing.
Nice.
Well, with that,
I think that's a wrap.
Do you want to do our traditional closing?
Sure, give me a sec. There we go. If you would like to wish me a happy birthday, there's plenty of ways you can do that. You can pop over to our website, comesoutloud.com, shoot us an email, comesoutloud@gmail.com. Leave us voicemail, 361, say we'll talk. That's 361-265-8255. I do need somebody to leave a message so that we don't lose it. Or you can follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube at Comes Out Loud in the appropriate place of the URL, or chat with some of these fine folks over on Telegram at tinyurl.com/telegram-col. You can also find out when we're planning on recording these shows by checking out our Google Calendar at tinyurl.com/calendar-col. You have various accoutrements, such as a logo shirt, a Consent is My Foreplay shirt, and many others, or a handy towel, or a mug, many things. At zazzle.com/cubsoutloud. Some of his designs were designed by Smashy. You can find more of his work at tpublic.com/user/smashysbear. You can also subscribe to us at Patreon at patreon.com/cubsoutloud. Or if you would like to just send us a donation, you can do that at paypal.me/cubsoutloud. You can subscribe to us and rate us and review us over on Apple Podcasts, Google Play, Spotify, Amazon, Audible, and a plethora of other places where you can find any podcast. The more you rate us and review us, the more people find us in the algorithm. You can find me anywhere on the internet as Boxset, Box Puppy, Box Cub, Box something or other, and Wingem, WYNDGEM on Twitch, where I stream Bears and Dragons every other Thursday. Damon?
If you wish to get in touch with me, you can find me as TheaterCub79, that's TheaterCub79, on most bear-related sites are on Facebook. Or you can find me as Pup_Umbra on Twitter. The Twitter is definitely not safe for work.
If you would like to get in touch with me, you can pretty much find me anywhere online as GearBear73.
And with that, Owen, did you want to pimp yourself for anything?
Well, I have two Twitters, one safe for work, one not safe for work. I think the first one that's safe for work is OwenROAN_R. And the not safe for work is AwkOwen, AWQ_OAN. I have Facebook, it's just under my usual name, my normal name, my not preferred name, Howard Naung. And I have an Instagram, which is probably the thing I frequent most besides Twitter for all the sexy matters. And my Instagram is, I think my Instagram's Owen, but I don't know. But yeah, that's all the places I'm at.
And with that, say goodnight, everybody.
Good night, everyone.
Have a good one, y'all.
Bye.